Hello friends, today in this tutorial we will be building this Angular material data table inside our Angular 9 application from scratch. So this is the data table. At the end of this tutorial we will be building a materialized data table. So it has rows and columns like this, a simple table. So now this is my app.module.ts file inside my brand new Angular project. So first of all we need to import this library. So we will write here import statement. So we will be importing it from @angular/material/table, and from that we need to import the mat table module. So this is a mat table module. After importing it, we also need to add it inside our imports array. So just add this mat table module. So now you just need to close this file. Now we are done with this file. Now open the app.component.html file where we will be initializing the table tag. So we have initialized the materialized table tag. It takes two properties. First is the data source property. So this data source will be the actual data which will be coming to this data table. So you can see that all these rows and columns constitutes this data source. So we need to provide externally inside our app.component.ts file. Here we need to create this variable that we are initializing here, which is data source. So that I will declare, and the next is the class. So we are providing this additional class which is mat.elevation.z8. So this is a materialized class. So this will provide this styling class, this border effect, the border shadow effect to this data table. That's it. Pause the video, just write this code. Now we will be constructing this data source. For this, first of all we need to create a simple interface where we will define the properties that will go inside this table. So this is pretty simple, like this. We will define this interface, let's suppose user. You can give any name of your choice. Inside this we will have four properties: name of the user, age, subject and country. So here this, I can just copy this and I can paste it inside my app.component.ts file like this. So after doing this guys, the next step is to define the properties which will be coming. So like this, you can just make a array. So here I have just provided the values here like this. So just put a comma here. So you can see that name John, age 23, subject computer science and country America. So I have just copy pasted these much of entries. You can just change the value accordingly. And this is the array that I have constructed. So I can just copy this also and just paste it here after the interface like this. So we are just making use of the interface that we have created in the earlier step. So this contains four properties: name, age, subject, country. So that is why we have provided these four properties. So I have not have enough time in the video, so you can just change these values accordingly. So after providing the rows and columns, in the next step we need to initialize the columns. So what we can do here is that we can copy paste this line. So this generally means that we are initializing the columns. So we are initializing a new variable. So inside this you need to copy paste it, this export class app component. Just paste this line. So we are defining the columns. So let me just write a simple comment. So here we are defining our columns inside the displayed columns variable. So the same variables that we have declared, name, age, subject and country, four columns are there, you can see that. Now we need to initialize it to the data source variable like this. Data source will be equal to the element data. So this, I can copy this line and paste it just after this. So now the data source variable is getting the data. So here we are just initializing the data source, the actual data that needs to be rendered inside the table. So data source will be equal to the array of values that we have defined in this element data variable. So now we are getting these data source variable correct. Now what we want here is that we want to construct our column like this. So with the ng container tag, so here it takes one property which is mat column definition. So this needs to be named because we have defined this inside app.component. So this needs to be named. So whatever value that you provide here, you need to provide the same value here. So this you can change here. This is the label of the column. So I will just change it to a capital letter name dot, and then this element dot name. So this, these are the values that it will take. So the first value will be John, and John, it will print all these name properties inside this double curly brackets. And similarly, we need to repeat this process for the rest of the column. So I can just copy paste it three more times. So here I will change the value to age. So this will change to age, and this one will change to element dot age. And next one we will have our subject. So this I will change it to subject, and this needs to be element dot subject. And the last one will be the country. So this I will change to country, and this one element dot country. That's it. So now we have all the columns and their definition. So the last step which is remaining here, we need to add our table row. So the actual row that needs to be inserted inside the table. So if we don't add this statement, then the rows will not be rendered inside the table. So this statement is very much necessary. So table row, it takes this mat dash header row and mat header row definition variable. So this is equal to the displayed columns variable that we have initialized inside app.component. So this takes all the column names, name, age, subject, country. And now it displays the columns. And the last one is the actual rows that are inserted. So this is again a table row, and inside mat row definition, just declare two variables, row and columns. And this one again is equal to the displayed columns. That's it. So now if I refresh the application, so you will see that, guys, it will name, age, subject and country. So it is not aligning properly, this data table. Now to fix this, it is pretty simple. Go to your app.component.css and just add this simple style, target the table tag and increase the width to 100%. That's it. So this is a simple style that you need to write, and after reloading the application, now it will take the full space of the application like this. You can see that this is our own data table that we have constructed from scratch. It has got four columns: name, age, subject, country. And at any point of time, if you want to stretch the table, if you want to add another entry, you can add it at any point of time. So you can add this like this. If you have, let me just add this entry. Let me just copy this. Let me just add this manually. So I will name, let's suppose this age 45, subject this one, and country again some random text. So now we have added a entry inside our table. So if I refresh, now your entry has been successfully added. So if you want to add some more column names, you can just modify the interface and then add the appropriate column name value. So this was the full tutorial on Angular Material Data Table, how to construct it from scratch. So if you like this tutorial, guys, please like the video and subscribe the channel, and also tap the notification bell icon. And I will be seeing you the next video.